BBC Five Live. 5 to 5 now. The Duke of Cambridge and Prince Harry have visited the Royal Foundation Support for Grenfell Community Hub this afternoon. It's based in North Kensington. And he's going to provide additional mental health resources for children, young people and families who were affected by the disaster. Our reporter Stephen Chittenden is there. What's it like, Stephen? Who have you been talking to?
Well, Tony, the Duke of Cambridge and Prince Harry just left in a car to go on to another engagement. They came here about three quarters of an hour ago. The Royal Foundation that they set up, along with the Duchess of Cambridge, set up this thing called Support for Grenfell Community Hub. And it's effectively just a building where a whole load of charities can provide a lot of support for people who are caught up in the fire. The tower is just a few hundred yards from the building. You can see it as I stand outside the building. And they spent some time inside talking to the charity workers who work primarily with mental health issues, but all sorts of other things too. Also some one or two community leaders, local head teachers. Among the people they spoke to was Professor Chris Imafidon, who's from the Excellence in Education, which is in trying to ensure that the children caught up go on to succeed in their education. Is that right?
That's right. We had to write to UCAS to let them know that every single undergraduate offer that was given to anybody from the tower is honoured. You have to completely discount their A-level results because they've gone through the fire, really. They should be given their places. And the sixth formers, we also fought for them in terms of their GCSE results.
Very interesting that it was very controlled on their way in, quite a sombre atmosphere. I mean, there are still yellow ribbons, still people missing from Grenfell, signs up asking people not to take photos and so on. And yet, when they came out, there was quite a crowd of local people, and Harry and William spent quite a long time just talking to them here, didn't they?
It almost brought tears to my eyes. It reminds me of their mother. They completely undermined protocol. Told the police, please stand aside, and they asked the local people, looked them in the eye, and then answered their questions. This is what politicians don't do nowadays, and yet they are the monarchy, and they are interacting with people, total and complete strangers.
It's interesting you mentioned their mother, because a few days ago you gathered quite a lot of publicity when you said that if Princess Diana were alive today, she would be here. Well, her boys are here today.
That's correct. That's what astonishes me. It really shows that Kensington Palace is ready to respond to the needs of the community, to the needs of the people, and completely forget about the class barrier, the protocol, and want to really hear the cries of the people and empathise with them. And that really shows a unique connectivity like we've never seen before in Wilroy.
Who are you speaking to, William or Harry or both?
Both of them.
And what were you saying? What were they saying to you?
If Harry was a person that spoke to me first, you're not supposed to talk. He spoke to me and said, how wonderful the work we're doing in working with the youths, and that here they don't just want to have this a one-off thing. They want to have a real institution there that will respond to the needs of the children. They will look at the mental needs of the children and be able to assist, because you know this community has been failed by officialdom. So for us to have the monarchy literally stepping in through different charities that they support to try and help the community, it was really a good blessing and a good day for the people.
I saw that they were on just bending down, talking to the children, shaking their hands.
Anybody, you know, this is why it reminds me of when Diana went under the bridge in Waterloo to sit next to homeless people and talk to them about their needs. That's essentially what they are doing today. They are connecting with your heart rather than using their head.
Okay. Well, Professor Chris Imafidon, thank you very much from Excellence in Education.
Cheers. Thank you.
Stephen, thank you as well.